everyone, and welcome. My name is Matt. I'm part of the Xero API team, and today we're looking at setting up Postman to connect to Xero via PKCE grant type. So recently, we've released the PKCE grant type for mobile and desktop apps, and today we thought we'd release another tutorial to showing you how to set it up inside of Postman. Just right off the bat, if you are looking for a day-to-day setup for testing with Postman Xero, we would suggest just using the regular auth code grant type, as it is a little bit easier to set up and you have a little bit less configuration to do. However, if you are going to be setting up a mobile or desktop app to connect to Xero, this is actually a really good idea just to set up, to have a look at and set up and see how things basically go around. So let's get started. So first thing you need to do is come across to Xero and, the My App Center and so the Developer Center, and create a new PKCE grant type app. So of course I've got a couple of details plugged in here already, name of my app. Make sure you click the PKCE grant type button right here and fill in your company and application URL. You don't have to worry about the privacy policy again. And then the OAuth2 redirect URI, of course you need in there as well. You can edit a second one if you need to. Click your agree to the terms and conditions, and then fantastic, there we go. So we've created ourselves a brand new app, Postman PKCE app, and good to go. Right, so what we're going to do after that is we will have this tutorial here available up on our GitHub and on the Developer Center soon enough. We'll have a link to those inside of the YouTube comment here, or description area, sorry. But what you need to do is first click the Run in Postman button that you'll find at the top of the URL. Click Postman for Windows. And open in Windows, or of course you are in OS. So there we go. So what that will do is import your environment up here in the top right, and then your collection over here in the left hand side. Okay, so now that we've done that, we're going to have to start plugging in a couple of details. So what you want to do is come across to the get authorization call, and then you can see here's a whole bunch of details we've got right here to fill in. So let's go back to our My App screen, copy out your client ID. So here's one of the big things that's the main difference for PKCE, is that it doesn't have a client secret. You'll be using an S256 encrypted code verifier and challenge across these. So every time that you want to connect and have a session, you'll be using a different one of these. However, in Postman, you can use the same one just because it's a Postman, a test environment. However, in a live environment, we would strongly recommend not having that, okay? So make it a different one every single time. So, of course, copy out your client ID, copy the clipboard, chuck that into the get authorization call, come across the parameters, and then in client ID, of course, just paste that in. Your redirect URI, you wanna do the same thing. Make sure it's exactly the same, including any slashes on the end. State, the state is optional. However, if you're not including a state, make sure you untick it here, and as well, you'll have to turn it off inside of your environment as well. But just to save us any worries, let's just include it anyway. And then a code challenge. Now, the code challenge is, we have found this fantastic tool that someone has created helpfully online that will create, where is it? Generate a code challenge, here we go. So just inside there, the online PKCE generator tool. So what we're going to do is, so this is basically our client secrets now. So we're going to create a code verifier. Now this has to be between 40, I can't remember the number, the minimum characters at the moment, but at least 40 characters long. It will be on inside of that tutorial to tell you exactly how many you actually need. It's actually on our flow page as well at the moment. So if you want to have a look at the PKCE flow, you can come across to here and click on PKCE flow. There we go. There you go. 43 characters and 128 characters long. So A to Z. It has to be ASCII characters as well. So capital A to Z, lowercase a to Z, 0 to 9, and these couple special characters, punctuation characters here. Okay, so let's create a code verifier. I'm going to say this is my code 123. and go, so there we go. This is my code 123 copied 4 times across, and then generate my code challenge. Leave this page open for now, because we will be coming back to grab the code verifier and the code challenge later on. So let's just copy out our code challenge and then paste it into there. Now, the main difference with this tutorial and the last tutorial is that there's no native support for PKCE grant type inside Postman. So what we're doing with this get authorization call, we're not actually using the call and sending it to, they're sending it, because all you're going to get down here is, if we've got a preview, something went wrong. There we go, code challenge required, even though we do actually have one up here. So what we're going to do is simply copy out the entire get call, come up to a new page, slap that in, and if we've done everything correctly, there we go. Now, I was already logged in, but if you hadn't been logged in recently, you will be asked to log in, and then of course you have authenticator as well. You'll be asked to add your authenticator code. So I'm going to select my demo company, and then of course whatever scopes that you... I forgot to mention the scopes as well. If you have your scopes that you'll be using can be added right here as well. For this one, we're just going to be using OpenID, profile, email, accounting transactions, and offline access. If you're not sure what scopes you need access to, you need to have to access certain resources, just come across to the OAuth2 page inside of Xero and check your scopes down here as well. So I like that. I'm happy with all these things right here. Let's allow access. There we go. So now I've been redirected back to my URI site in my URI, and I've been given this code right here. So what we want to do is copy out the code, go back to Postman, go to our post token one, come across to the body call, and then chuck that in there. Okay. Now, at this stage, we're also going to fill out all of our PKCE environment bits and pieces as well, variables. So again, like before, let's fill out 123 for our state. Let's go back to our online generator tool, grab the verifier and challenge. So that was, which one did I grab? That was the verifier. And then your challenge. Fantastic. Redirect URI again. Luckily, they're the same, so I can just copy that one. Stop opening Slack. Now, you can leave the Xero tenant ID access refresh token at the moment, but we will need our client ID. We'll be generating these three values in our next step. Lovely. There we go. And let's just double check that they all went in. Fantastic. There we go. So actually, tell you what, we'll leave that right there for now for this part of the tutorial. If you do have any questions, please feel free to reach out at api@xero.com or go to the Xero Central and we'll raise a case, and we'll be happy to answer any questions. And the next step, we'll be posting our token and retrieving back our connections, the tenant ID, the refresh token, access token, and all that stuff, adding that back into here and carrying on. Thanks, guys. Bye-bye.